today. Maybe we could go out and bring in a few this morning. Well, we appreciate all of you that are here. At this time, we invite you to let the prelude draw you into worship.
Thank you.
are. God will always give you healing.
We come praying and praising.
Blessed are you whose faith is in the Lord.
For in God's love and healing power, we are strengthened to be of service to others. Amen.
You may be seated. We invite the children to come forward for the Young Disciples lesson.
God, we thank you so much for everything that you have given to us. Lord, use us and use our gifts and talents to build and expand your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks, guys.
Hi, everybody. This is the time of year where we do our stewardship campaign. As you're all aware, this has been an unusual year, and the pandemic has had countless effects on all of us. I think you could say we're all a little bit tired. And that, along with trying to minimize contact between everyone, we're going to skip our usual campaign this year, where we distribute packets to everyone and ask you to put your financial pledge down on paper for the coming year. Instead, we are imploring and entrusting you all to continue your 2020 pledge and giving throughout 2021. And of course, if you're able to increase your giving a little bit, that would be great also. Doug and I always do our giving through automatic withdrawal. It's super easy and it's safe, and all it takes is authorization form. I've got a stack of those on the ledge by Amy's office if you want to grab one and start giving that way. Or maybe you already give that way and would like to increase your giving a little bit. However you give, whether it's cash, check, or automatic withdrawal, just please continue. We are all depending on each other. As I say, it takes a village. And now Brad's going to give some financial information. Thanks for listening.
I'd like to take a couple of minutes to visit with everyone about the finances of the church. The good news is that because of your continued financial support, all things considered, we continue to weather 2020 reasonably well. Thank you for your devotion to the church. The bad news is, of course, that no one knows how much longer we're going to have to deal with all things COVID. So here's how we look at through the end of September. Year-to-date giving was $291,000, more or less, which is a decrease of $22,000 over this time last year. Expenses were around $311,000, which is almost identical to what they were last year. As a result, we're showing an operating loss of around $19,000 as far as general fund versus general expenses concerned. Having said all that, giving is still $27,000 ahead of budget, which sounds a bit contradictory. How can we have an operating loss and still be ahead of budget? Keep in mind that every year our giving commitments generally run about 80% of the budget. So giving is almost always going to be ahead of the budget. Expenses came in around $22,000 under budget, which is certainly a good thing for us. The church's balance sheet looks pretty healthy right now. As of September 30th, the checking account had a little over $71,000 in it. However, the church was able to obtain a PPP loan for about $68,500. So whenever you keep that in mind, if you pull that money out, we ended up with a checking account balance of around $3,000, which is pretty tight. Our savings account has about $145,000 in it, which includes sanctuary renovation funds to repay the loan, capital improvement funds, as well as some memorial money. There's also some other funds that are deposited in there that are dedicated to one thing or another. And so far as the church's liabilities go, the renovation loan has been paid down to $55,716.
I thank God for, you know, so many generous people in our church. As God has been generous to us and to our church, let us continue to be generous, both our givings and our lives, so that we might make a difference in this community. May the Lord bless us. May the Lord be with us as we go into this week to serve as Jesus served and to love as Jesus loved. Amen. Go in peace.